Hi, welcome to Simple Believer TV. This is Justin, and today we're going to talk about the mind. I have an awesome opportunity every other Wednesday to come together with a group of men, and we just discuss how to grow in the things of God, identity and leadership. And one of the things that I've consistently seen is this misunderstanding when it comes to resisting the enemy. Now, it's very clear in the book of James that we are to resist the enemy, submit ourselves unto God, and resist the enemy, and he will flee. But how do we resist is the biggest question, is how do we win this battle? Because we first must understand that the battle is right here in the mind, that the enemy is attempting to plant a negative thought with the hope or with the intention of persuading our emotions and our feelings. Because if he can get us to be moved by how we feel, to assess life and assess God and feel a certain way, then he can maneuver us any way that he wants, because our feelings could go here one day, happy, sad, disappointed, discouraged, up and down, there's hope, no hope. And if he can get you moving in your emotions and your feelings, that's where he wins. And I'm amazed at times, even with myself, how quickly we put down the sword of the Spirit, maybe take off the armor of God, and we just stop fighting. Like, we believe at some level that if I pray enough, go to church enough, serve enough, give enough, then I won't have the fight come to me. But all of those things prepare you to fight. They prepare you to be the overcomer that you already are. So the fight does not mean that you are trying to get victory. No, you're fighting from a place of victory. He is trying to steal something from you. He's trying to steal your joy, and he's trying to steal the real estate space up here in your mind so that he can occupy it with his thoughts rather than with God's thoughts. And so I want to encourage you with this one thought when it comes to the fight, is that the word of God is the sword of God. And the way that you override this is with this. If you are not speaking what God said into your situation, and there's nothing magical about me speaking something and magically everything goes away. No, this is to change this. So when he plants a thought that, you know what, just end your life. There's no reason to live. You're not going to make it out of here. This is wrong, and you failed at this, and you're just going to continue to fail, and you're never going to overcome this. Those are thoughts that have been planted to get you to be persuaded at the core of your emotion. You're right, and you lose hope, and you lose joy, and you lose peace. But if you will take this mouth and start to say, you know what? I reject that negative thought. I will not fail because I am an overcomer. I'm a victor in Christ, and I will win. I will get out of this. God will deliver me. I will not succumb to my negative thinking. I will not succumb to the emotions that I'm facing. I'm going to come out of this. That's when you start to override your mind. You start to persuade and renew your mind to your Father's way of thinking. And you're using the sword of the Spirit like the enemy did in the garden. It is written. He said that to the enemy, and the enemy left. So when you resist the enemy, resist him with your mouth. When he plants a negative thought, you now declare a positive one that comes from a promise that God declared over you in the Scriptures. As you speak the word of God, you now are dismissing and putting away the voice or the negative thought inside your mind. We are in a fight. It's called the good fight of faith. And the reason why it's good is because we win, and because it's a worthy one, because we are called to represent Christ. So please, if you're on the other side of this camera lens, I want to encourage you, don't stop fighting. Know that the enemy is at times very relentless, but you will outlast him if you continue to keep your mouth open. When you refuse to talk the word of God and try to just battle the enemy with another thought, you lose. It's like having a gun but never pulling the trigger. You just have a gun and you're threatening to do something. Eventually, you will be overcome because you never pulled the trigger in battle. So use the word of God. Use your mouth. How do we know when we're supposed to use it? When you don't feel like it. That's when you do it. When you feel negative and you feel down, that's when you open up your mouth and declare something that is true about what God said. Be encouraged today. You will win. The enemy is a liar. He's a deceiver. He's coming to steal something that is already yours. Don't give him the opportunity to do it. Use your mouth to override the seeds that have been planted by the enemy, and you will walk in victory every day of your life. Have a great day. Thank you for stopping by the channel. Feel free to share it with as many people as you know need to hear what I just shared. Bye-bye.